Number one. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Tremendous show, tremendous success.
Hello everyone, Mark the Statman Skevich, Real Fans Real Talk, here at the 50th anniversary of Rucker Park, here with one of the iconic legends in women's basketball, Teresa Witherspoon. Thank you for coming on the program.
Absolutely, thanks for having me.
All right, now you've had a lot of accomplishments in the sport of basketball, a coaching career, playing career, Olympic gold medalist. What would you say is your biggest moment in your career?
I can't pinpoint that. That's really, really difficult to pinpoint. The biggest thing and the greatest thing for me is the opportunity, because you have to take a true advantage of an opportunity. So it's been just great to have an opportunity to play a game that I was gifted at playing and love so very much at playing. But it's never a one thing when it comes to the game. It's the opportunity and taking advantage of the opportunity.
Now, you're one of the pioneers of the WNBA back in 1997 when the league started with the New York Liberty. What was that feeling like, being there, one of the first to ever do it?
Man, you know, it was amazing to play in Madison Square Garden. I'm sure it was amazing for all the other young ladies and the teams in which they played for. But we were playing in New York City. We were playing in Madison Square Garden. We were playing in front of the greatest fans there is in the world. So it was an exciting moment for us all to be able to play back in America and play a game we love in America, because we were all basically overseas playing, because that was our dream, was to be able to play, continue after college, and we played overseas. But to come back in America and be chosen to play in New York City in Madison Square Garden, that was the greatest feeling in the world.
Now, when did you fall in love with the sport of basketball?
I was very young. I'm from a family of nothing but athletes, and I'm the baby. So I had to fall in love some kind of way, but they said I picked up a ball at 4 years old and just started playing with it. And my family, brothers and sisters, pushed me with the game of basketball and many other sports, because I'm from a very small place. So all I did was play every sport possible with the guys all the time.
Now, growing up as a kid, did you ever think imaginable that there would be a WNBA and that you would be playing for them?
Well, you know, we never imagined that. We were trying to take advantage of the opportunities that were before us. And the ultimate at that time was to be an Olympian. So everybody was shooting to be an Olympian, and that's only 12. You only get 12 of those, so it was limited space, so to speak, for all the athletes, women, great athletes, in the game of basketball. So that was the ultimate for us. And then if you wanted to play collegiately, you had to go overseas. So it was trying times at points, but to have the WNBA come into existence because of our 96 Olympic team, showing everybody that women can play this game, we play it at a very high level, and we're professionals.
Now, still involved with the Liberty, showing up here at Rucker Park. There's the saying, once a Nick, always a Nick. I guess the same is true with the Liberty. Once a Liberty, always a Liberty.
You better know it. You better know it. We're all Liberty for life. You know, we put that uniform on. We put the uniform on as a family, as a unit who played together, fought together. And once you put that uniform on, we're going to always be together as a family. And so we're all Liberty for life, and I'm definitely Liberty for life.
Now, some of the highlights as a player of the New York Liberty, you had the half-court shot and the finals. Is there, I know you don't have a favorite career moment, but what about as far as highlight plays? Does anything stand out? Is that it, the half-court shot, or does something else come to mind?
You know, I think that's what everybody thinks about when they think about the shot. You know, they think about, wow, that was a highlight moment. But for me, it was playing defense and passing the ball. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed making a great pass. I enjoyed watching my teammates make a nice shot or finish that pass, and then defending. You know, that's the gritty side of the game. And I was a gritty kind of player, kind of lived like the city. I grind. I was trying to grind it out every night, and those were my moments. I love stopping people. I love putting that blanket over people. I enjoyed that. I enjoy passing the basketball. But when you talk about a moment, that's a moment that everybody thinks of, and I appreciate it.
All right. It's common for men to teach females in the sport of basketball. We're seeing it now with Becky Hammon and winning the Summer League with the Spurs. Do you think it's a short time before we have a pioneer? Will it be Becky Hammon or someone else soon that coaches professionally in the NBA?
Well, you know, we're very, very proud of what Becky's doing. It's no surprise. We're not like trying to create millions and millions of headlines that she did it. We're just proud of her because we know that she has the knowledge of the game, and that's what Pop saw. He saw a person with knowledge who can come in and make his players better. And that's what she's doing. And it's just great for those doors to be open. And when those doors open, those who feel like that's something they desire to do, you get in those doors also. So it's only a matter of time. It's only a matter of time because the trust is there. And I believe men understand that women play this game at a high level and we're very knowledgeable about the game. And that's the respect factor that has to come in order.
All right. Now, we're here at the Rucker 50th anniversary. Madison Square Garden is the mecca of sports. Rucker Park has its own aura. Do you have any favorite players in Rucker Park or moments in Rucker Park?
I've always been out here. From my start of being a part of the Liberty, I wanted to get out here immediately to see the atmosphere. I was very, very close. It's like a little brother of mine, Tim Headache Giddens, brought me out here, and I got an opportunity to be a part of this atmosphere. And, man, I started to feel what it's like to play out here, and I actually wanted to have an opportunity to play out here as well because of the many people who've played out here, because this is historical. This is very historical, just like Madison Square Garden. So anybody would love to be a part of this atmosphere. And, man, I'm back. I'm glad we're having this 50th year anniversary because there's been so many greats to come through to make this place what it is today.
All right, now, word around the campfire is you gave Allen Iverson a little trouble on one-on-one. How truth is that?
I don't know about that campfire. That campfire, it needs some water on that fire. No. I've always watched him. I enjoyed the fire that this man brought to the game. To be as small as he was, to play the game as hard as he did, he was simply amazing. No one should ever forget what he brought to the game of basketball and how hard he played. He gave his heart and his soul. And I know being a 76er has meant the world to all those people in Philly because he brought them excitement night in and night out, and that can never be forgotten, never. I mean, the crossover, that's freaking unbelievable.
Yeah, crossing over Jordan, too.
But as small as he was, he can get to that rim and finish over anyone. Mm-hmm. Shoot the basketball, handle the basketball, pass the basketball, play defense. So when you can put all those things together in that little package that he brought every night, man, it says a lot. He's huge.
Have you ever had any one-on-ones with any NBA players?
Not any one-on-ones, never had any one-on-ones, had an opportunity to play with a lot of them, and that was key. It's fun. You know, the game of basketball is just simply fun. And when you're playing with them, you take some things that they do, and you learn from it and implement it into your game. Because you can only learn when you're playing with men of that caliber, and that's what I always wanted to do. I like playing against the men to prepare myself for my season.
All right, Mark Skevich, Real Fans Real Talk, alongside Teresa Weatherspoon, one of the pioneers in women's basketball, one of the all-time greats, legend. Thank you for coming on the program.
Thank you, I appreciate it. Boom!
Tremendous show, tremendous success.